into this video. This thing always gives me a problem. Let's see here. This is good. Okay, that's good. And let's get back to the video. Let's see, let me go back to my dashboard. Just getting things ready if anybody's watching. I'm not in the video just yet. Just getting into it now. Just getting all the technical stuff out of the way. Here we go. Hola Isabel, ¿cómo estás? Just gonna give people a few minutes to get themselves in and hi Brandy. I haven't started anything yet. So far I'm just giving people a few minutes to get in. So I can show you guys some of the stuff that I done did. And then we're going to get into making a paper purse. Like this one that I made. I added some of those chains that Myra sent me on our Happy Mail exchange. And I think it came out gorgeous. So I'm going to try to recreate this. She had asked me to show her how I did the buckle. And I know I did a tutorial on this one, but I figured if I do it live with you guys, I'll be able to talk to you guys and it'll be a little bit better. It's okay. At least you came by and said hello. I appreciate that. Good, good. Here on a Saturday evening. Trying to get some crafting done. Thank you. The other thing I did, which I have to make the video, but I already recorded and everything. My very first friendship umbrella. So I did this whole thing and I recorded it, luckily this time. And I'm going to put this up soon. And it opens up really wide. So it came out pretty good for my first one. I didn't put nothing on the back though. Just kind of left it like that. These are fabric flowers. So pretty much what I did, I bought a yard of this off of eBay a while ago, and cleaning my stash, I found it. So they have like little pearls in the center, so I ripped off those pearls and I put them aside for something else. They're kind of hooked up with like a little metal something there. So I took them off, and then Tina from Starting Over had, she sent in her entry, she sent me these little buttons. They're literally like little gems, which are these right here. So I just hot glued those on and then just added some of that pearl trim to make it look like little flowers kind of sticking out. Hi, Liz. So this is kind of how I did that. And I have the video. I just have to do the whole thing. The only thing is that I'm not really good at the tutorials on video, which is why most of the time you guys won't hear me talk through them. Like and there goes my phone. It's like it always knows when I'm live. Give me a second, you guys. This this phone always knows when I'm recording or when I'm live. It won't ring the whole day. But heavens to Betsy. Let me get on and try to do a video, and it'll start going off like wildfire. It's like allergic to me making videos or something. So I forgot what I was saying. Oh, you made a fan for me? Oh, for who? Oh, no, you made one for Barry, not for me. Here I am getting confused. This is what happens when you step out for a second. Everything kind of takes over. But yeah, so I kind of used some of the pearl trims and hooked this bad boy up. I'm still not sure if I'm going to include this in the giveaway that I'm doing, or if I'm going to give it away through Happy Mail. I'm not sure, but I'm still kind of debating that. But I did like how it came out. So chances are I'll definitely be making more. The only thing I don't really like about the umbrella is the, you know, the little wand thing, you know, the handle, right? Because it does look like an umbrella. I mean, you got to give it that much. But the wand is like a little, since you have to hot glue it to the paper, it's a little, like, it's well glued, but it has too much movement for my liking. And I just feel like it's something that could be easily torn off, but I mean, it holds together well so far, so we'll see. We'll see. So, today, to get going with what we came here for, we're going to be recreating a paper purse, hopefully with all the bells and whistles. I aim to get this thing done completely today. And I did a tutorial on this, but I didn't really speak through it, so I figured I might as well just do a live for it. That way you guys can ask me if you have anything to ask, as far as how I did it, so on and so forth. And that way the video will be a little bit more informative, if you will, than the first video, that I did. I got the tutorial for how to do that from Crafty Ella Designs here on YouTube. Which I kind of found while doing a search for paper purses, just to see like different styles and stuff like that. So the how to make it, I got from her. The strap, that's my idea. I mean, I don't know if anybody else is doing it, but I kind of did that on my own. I didn't get that off of her tutorial. She went a completely different style with it, which is beautiful as well. But how I did this part of it, I just thought that it'll look cleaner if I tucked it in, and hopefully the buckle itself won't get like frayed and damaged from constantly pulling it, pulling it on and pushing it on, pulling it off and pushing it on. So that's kind of why I did that. Hola, Barbie. So pretty much I got here two sheets of paper, two 12 by 12. One of them is going to be the main construction of my purse. And then the other one is going to be used for the buckle and for maybe some pocket accents, depending on how, you know, we go about this whole situation. Because I still haven't thought this whole thing through, which, as you guys know, is typical of me. I've gone ahead and, since what I have is a 6x6 scoreboard, I don't have a 12x12. These measurements are for a 12x12, so I kind of pre-marked it already on my paper, which is something that you guys can do if you don't have a 12x12. Just grab yourself a ruler, which is what I did, and just, you know, go marking off all the little areas where you know you need to score so that you have all your measurements in place. And yeah, let's get this show on the road. And let's see what else we can squeeze in here. I don't know how long this is going to take me today. When I did this one, it took me a little while because I'm still a little fresh. So pretty much according to Craftiella's design tutorial that I saw, depending on the paper that you have, if you have like a certain pattern that you want to be the front, you know, like be the front of your purse, then that's the side that you want to score first, okay? So since this paper, it's kind of universal, if you will, like the flowers go in every which way, there's really no need for that, so I just pretty much just marked it in certain areas. So I don't know if you guys want to write this down or not. That's completely up to you. But my first set of score lines are going to be at 3 1/4 and 8 3/4. And that's going to be on the side that I want facing the front. and I got my phone fully charged, so hopefully there'll be no issues today with the recording. And I kind of need to see this, so 3 1/4. So the first thing I'm going to do is score at my 3 1/4 line. All the way down. And then I'm just going to move this over and score pretty much around here somewhere, which will be my 8 3/4 line. But since I don't have an 8 3/4 line, I'm just going to pick a line and stick to it. And I marked my paper on both sides so that when I had to rotate it, I wasn't going to get lost. I thought ahead this time, you guys. I'm proud of myself. I was like, you know what? No. Make your lines first so you don't look like a freaking fool on live trying to figure out these measurements and trying to get all of this stuff, you know, scored properly. So we got our two lines, right? So this will be the front, if you will. I scored this way and this way. So this will be more or less the front. Now we're going to rotate the paper so that the lines are horizontal. Your first score lines are horizontal. And then we're going to go into this and score at the next set of scores are 3 1/4, 4 1/2, 7 1/2, and 11 1/4. So pretty much a 3 1/4 on both ends, and then the 4 1/2 and 7 1/2. So how's everybody's Saturday today? Hopefully everybody's having an awesome day. So I'm just gonna go ahead and score this. And I'm gonna go ahead and score at my 3/4 mark here as well, because these are gonna be exactly the same. And then I'm going to score at 4 1/2. I got to get a 12 by 12, you guys. This little thing is driving me crazy. It's raining over there. I'll take rain any day over how cold it is in New York right now. Like, literally, you turn to an ice cube the minute you, like, stick your head out the window, go out the door. I have socks up to my thighs right now. I feel like a grandma. Like, it's so crazy. It is so, so crazy how this weather just shifts. It went from hot as heck to frigid outside in a matter of minutes. So I'm just rotating my paper so that I can get in line with the little score marks that I made over here, so that I can follow this kind of all the way through. And this is my 7 1/2 score line here. Okay. So you're going to have one side that's going to have 3 1/4. 3 1/4, 3 1/4. And then you're going to have the one score line at 4 1/2. And then the next score line is going to be at 7 1/2. Okay. And that's it for scoring. I mean, it's that simple. The rest is just gluing and putting it together. Yeah, it is cold. Oh, my God. It's so, so cold. I'm going to get a scissor because I'm going to need that. Now, in order to get this little section here, what you're going to want to do is on these parts here, you're going to want to cut, right? So you're going to hold it up where you have your quarter lines in the bottom and in the top, your 3/4 lines. And you're going to cut from the bottom all the way up to that score line there. So you have this one, and you're going to do that to the top, the two bottoms and also the top. And again on the second score line. Right to that middle section there. So So you have these things open like so. We're going to rotate this and do it on the other side. Hello, Abstract. Hi, Didi. Girl, I suck at measurements, Didi, let me tell you. I'm like the worst. So, in case you missed the front, the first one, pretty much, you see your ruler, right? You have your first long line is a quarter. The second one is a half. The third one is 3/4. And then you have your numbers. So all of those pretty much is just following all the way across. So if you can understand the 1 inch, don't worry so much about the rest of the 12 inches. If you can, if you could just focus on the 1 inch and just tell yourself that the very first long line, the longest line is first. That's your quarter mark. And then the second longest line is your half. Then the third longest line is your 3/4. Then you make it to your inch. And pretty much that's the rule for everything else. Now, when it comes to 5/8, 6/8, and 7/8, you know, that's where you lose me. But if you can at least get that part, then you'll be at least close to where you're trying to go as far as your measurements. That was like the hardest part for me. So I've been practicing. I've been practicing those measurements, let me tell you. I literally Googled it. Like, okay, what is this and what is that? And it doesn't help because it doesn't really show you the clearest way either. So I was still kind of lost. So like what I did, I don't know if you guys can see that very well, but I have all my little lines marked off. So every single one of those lines, all the way to an inch, I wrote them down. So the very first line is 1/8, the second line is 1/4, the third line is 3/8, then the fourth line is a half, the fifth line is 5/8, the sixth line is 3 1/4, then 7/8, and then we have the 1 inch. So that's pretty much what I did, and I stuck it on the board so I can keep myself, you know, so that I just count, like, I just count, you know, to the inch, and I'll know more or less which way I have to go. This is just little tips of stuff that I did. Aldi's is far from me. I literally have to take like a $20 cab ride just to get there. It's so far from me. So we have our flaps, right? So this is what you're going to see. And then this is going to be the main components, the front and back of your purse, right? With your folded lines over. These are your main purse components, right? Right here. This is your body. Your main body. This is too long. So what you want to do is you want to fold these over to that score line, give or take. It does not have to be perfect. And then we're going to cut this piece off because we don't need it. It's too long. We're going to do that to all four corners. And this is going to allow for you to fold the ends in a way that it looks nice and clean. So you have, everything is tucked in. Everything is going to be tucked in under this flap. So it'll all be nice and seamless. And depending on your pattern, you probably won't even tell that you did that at all. Aldi's be having some good stuff, man. I got a painting in my living room that I bought in Aldi's, like, oh my God. It must have been like, maybe like almost 18 years ago. And I still have it. And I bought it for like 20 bucks, I think, when I bought it. And it still looks exactly the same. Barry, did you get one? Did you get one of those rainbow cards? Is it well made? I think if I put one more item in here to store crafts, my husband's gonna freak out. So I don't know. As much as I want to get one, I don't know if he's gonna be too happy about me having another place to store more crafty stuff. All right, you guys, so we got our four tabs off, okay? So this is pretty much what your main body should look like. This is what your template is for you to pretty much create your purse. So I'm gonna go in and start scoring, well, folding some of these lines over. Okay, little stick, work with me, not against me. And I am loving these paper purses a little too much, I think. Did I cut all over there? Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did see the Lego picture that you put on your Instagram. That is very resourceful for that, let me tell you, especially for kids' toys. So it works well. Oh, thank you. This was given to me by Nick's Crafty Corner. She sent it in with her entry, so I put it on because I love all the colors. And it's Wonder Woman. What? So pretty much, this is how this is going to go. Okay. So this will tuck in here. This end is going to tuck in there. So you guys kind of get the drift there. And the same with this one. So these are going to kind of tuck in there. And then this is more or less the body, you know, once it's all closed up, the body of your purse. But I want to incorporate, I made this like a little pocket right here. So I want to be able to cut this out here on the sides, which I did on both. I did it on both sides. I cut that out. So I'm going to get something that's cylinder-like. And I mean round. Did I just say cylinder? That is round so that I can trace it and then I can cut it out before I start gluing anything. So let me grab one of my little handy-dandy bottles over here. And I'm just trying to see. I only do this to the one side because I stick this side on that side, trace around it, and then just cut it out. So I don't need to do it on both. I just want to make sure that it's somewhere in the center. And more or less going to cut that out. And then the rest of this is pretty much adorning it, making it look pretty. So I'm going to grab that. Now that I have that on this side, I'm going to come over here and hopefully put it around the same area. And just trace that so that I have the exact same cut. On both sides. Let me erase this from here. I don't need that. And cut this out. Michael's is ridiculous. I saw those pictures that you put up, Barry, of those dyes. That was crazy. How Michael's is gonna charge like four times the amount and you're gonna get it for like a quarter of the price over at Tuesday Morning. My mouth dropped. This is why I stick to eBay. And I do the dyes from China because that's where they send to make them anyway. My husband's messing with me, you guys. He's shushing me back here. So pretty much just cutting out the other little spot here. where my pocket is gonna go. And hopefully I did these about right. So this is pretty much what I have now. Okay. Then the rest, like I said, is just gluing. So, but since I'm not just gonna glue, because I also have to add the pocket section on this box, on this purse here, I lined the inside with black cardstock so that I can get these little pocket spaces here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the same, and I am gonna line it, but I'm thinking that I should line it with some of this paper here. So I'm gonna cut out some pockets and line it with this paper here instead. Sound is quiet. The sound is quiet. You guys can't hear me? Let me see. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Hi, Kimberly. I made tostones with fried chicken today. And my husband's laughing at me in the background. So if you guys hear me cracking up, that's probably why. He's making fun of me today. Got me some plantains. Some platanitos. So, is it still quiet? You can hear me? Oh, okay. You know, you guys know that my phone has betrayed me before. So I wasn't sure. Let me just see how deep these pockets go. So that I know where to cut. So we're about 3 inches and a quarter. Okay, so I'm gonna cut these strips about 3 inches and a quarter, but maybe I'm gonna cut them about 3 inches and make them a little shorter than the pocket itself. I'm not sure yet. We'll see what happens. Not to be able to see, because this thing got the worst lines here. I think that's a quarter there. I don't even know. Either way, I know it's a little bit more than 3. To the point of no return. Let's just make sure. It's a little bit up. It's like a little hairline more than I need. Let's see. Girl, that food done. They ate as soon as I put it on the plate. It was gone. It was going fast. They ain't playing. That food was gone quick. As long as it takes for me to make it for a whole family, they wasn't trying to hear that. It was like the car, right? Are we there yet? Except, is the food done? Is the food done? Is it done yet? Especially my little one. She ain't playing. Let's see here. All right, so I'm going to cut these at about 6 inches because I'm going to make 2 out of 1 because I don't need all that long strip for the pockets. Hi, Debbie. Thanks for joining us. So we're making paper purses. I've already cut this down to size, and this is pretty much what the template looks like for creating the paper purse, which you probably saw on my tutorial, but yeah, I'm going to add some pockets. So I cut 3 1/4 by 12, and I cut that down to 6, so 3 1/4 by 6, so that I can add that into the inside so that I can make some pockets out of this. Now I just have to see which way this is going to go. Making you hungry? So let's see here. I don't want it to be too deep, so I'm trying to figure out which is the best placement for this. And I think I'm going to have to score here. So I wasn't trying to score, but I think I'm going to have to score so I can get these pockets in nice and tight. With cilantro and onions. That sounds yummy. Not me. I make them like, I bread it up. I cut up the chicken into strips. And then I use some of the, I season them up Dominican style with the onion and the garlic and all the different seasonings and cayenne. Cayenne pepper and what's the other one? Jesus. There's another pepper there. There's one of those other peppers. So I put all those little different powders in it. And then I dip them in egg. And then I dip them into the breadcrumbs, the Italian breadcrumbs. And then I put them to fry. Yum, yum. Hi, Sharon Sherry. So that's pretty much how I do it. Well, at least how I did it today. So since you guys know I suck at measurements, pretty much what I'm going to do is the following. I'm going to line up my paper somewhat over here. And I'm just going to mark off the places where I need to score this paper at. So that I can make my life easy. Because it won't be fun if it's hard. And then right over here. So pretty much like this, and I probably overscored that one. No, it's pretty much okay. So pretty much like this. So I'm going to have this pocket on the inside, and I'm going to shade these edges up because you guys know I don't like them edges white. And I'm going to do the same thing for the other one and get those scored in. And let me score this one too so that I can get into this next part of it, and then I think that we'll be able to commence the gluing once I get all this shading done. So that's pretty much that. Get my little marks out of here. And let's see what we got next. Oh, yeah, shading. Let's add some shading to this. Now, where the heck is my ink? So I'm going to use the Studio G because it resembles a little bit the color. It's a little darker, but it still resembles it nicely. And I'm going to shade it in just a little bit. Make it look like it's kind of bleeding out a little bit. I'm not worried about the sides and the bottom because that's going to be in the inside. I'm just worried about this part here because that's the part that's going to be showing. Even though I did the whole thing, but that's just in case any little part of it ends up peeking through. And I'm just going to rub that in because I don't want it too dark. Just want a little subtle hint. Oh, yeah. I have taco night in my house at least once every other week. Sometimes twice. We love ourselves some tacos. All kinds. Chicken fajitas, chalupas, gorditas, flaquitas. We like them all. We like them all. Let me get some glue. Con chicharrón. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Chicharrón is off the hook. We as Spanish people cannot pass up some chicharrones. That's a damn shame. That's a damn shame. They so crispy. They so good. I don't like Spam. My mom gave us Spam so much when I was little, I'm spammed out. That is like the go-to food. It tastes so good though, because it's so salty. I like it, but I just can't do it no more. That's like an emergency food in my house. Okay, so I'm just trying to figure out how I'm gonna add these little pockets here. I'm thinking that these pockets are pretty much good to go, so I'm just gonna go ahead and glue these suckers on, and then we're gonna commence to folding everything together, and hopefully everything cooperates with me, because I have these little invisible gnomes that keep fiddling with my stuff. They keep knocking things right out of my hand. So I'm going to pretty much try to put this right where I need this to be. And hopefully, right over where the score line is, so that I'm not interfering with that fold. And I'm going to glue this one in. Carmen, do you cray cray? Hello, Spam. Con un huevito frito y un arroz blanco con ketchup. Y nos fuimos. Yeah. Mija, yo me crié en eso, let me tell you. Ese era el desayuno, el lunch y la cena, olvídate. That's what you call living ghetto fabulous right there. Que no hay de comer. ¿Qué? Mira, muchacha, fríete un huevo ahí, date un arroz, que you're good to go. Que no hay carne. Mira, muchacha, dale una lata de Spam. ¿Qué carne ni carne? Ahí está la carne. ¿Qué más carne que eso? Okay. So I pretty much put them scored with score line. So I'm going to have this little area kind of opened up. If you guys can see, there's like a, it's going to be like a little looped area there, which is pretty much how I wanted it. What's Spam? Spam is a can with every single meat product made into one with a little salt inside. Hells yeah. Y 10 plátanos por un peso. What? That's life right there. I mean, I don't know, now you get 3 plants for a dollar, but back then it was 10 of them for a dollar. We was eating for like a week. Y un salchichón, one of them long ones, forget about it. You good. That's what you call hood rich. That's what you call hood rich right there. What? And don't let me tell you what mother could do with a pernil. We'll be eating for a month, one of those suckers. So this is pretty much how I wanted it to be. I wanted the pocket to be popped out. So now when I insert everything, everything's going to be nice and open there. So I can just pretty much put anything, you know, any little package of something or the other. Yes, good times, good times. You ain't kidding. You brought me back with that one, let me tell you. You brought me back with that one. I could almost hear my mother ringing the buzzer, and I'm standing in front of the building. Mira, I need you to go to the store. But in Spanish. calling my name 1,000 times out the damn window. Que vaya para la bodega. Que tiene que comprar algo. Oh my God. That's so crazy. It's funny how your mind works. It could bring things back so fresh and pretty much make you feel like you're right there all over again. My mama was no joke, too. She had the loudest mouth on the block. And I was the only girl, so I was the go-to everything. I was the only girl and the oldest girl, so there you go. Mama part two over here. Okay, this one's a little bit higher than I need it to be, so I'm going to trim this off before I finish gluing this whole thing down. My mom was a trip. Is a trip, because thankfully, thank God, she's still here. She is a trip. She's still driving me crazy. Love my mama, though. Why did I do that? Why did I do that? I overcut. See what happens when you go into nostalgia lane? You overcut. There we go. Oh, please. Everybody knows my my official government. Because Carmen is just an abbreviation of what my real name is. Just so you guys know. It's just easier. Because people kept butchering my name, so I just shortened it. I lost a few letters along the way. And there goes my phone. Let's see if it's my mama texting. Nope, it's not her. I was going to say her ear is ringing right now. But please, don't let that woman get mad and call me out of a window or call me out the intercom. Oh my God, that was so embarrassing. When you hang in there with your friends, thinking you're all cute and stuff, laughing it up, and the next thing you know, you hear your name in 3D stereo with a hint of anger. No. Oh my God, that's too much. That's too funny. That is too funny. Everybody's like, uh-oh, there goes your mama calling. Oh God. Yeah. Deep. Okay, so this is almost done. If I'm still doing these lives for Halloween, I'm going to scare the bejesus out of you guys. I got some stories that won't let you sleep at night. Got some good old Halloween stories. Okay. Might do like a scary night special or something somewhere down the line. All right, you guys. I'm trying to see because I'm thinking that I want to stick this maybe. At least stick it there a little bit so that it's not so open. I'm going to stick it just in one little spot. I'm not going to close the whole thing off, but I do want to stick it at least right there. La chancla, Si nada más fuera la chancla, no fuera nada. Esa chancla no duele. I think she figured that out somewhere along the line. La chancla no duele, man. That thing is made of foam. I didn't even bother with mine, let me tell you. My kids don't even know what it is to get hit. Thank God. I think I earned those stripes. No need to pass on the favors. Didn't you guys hate that commercial? It's 10 o'clock at night. Do you know where your children are? That was my alarm clock. Heavens forbid I didn't get home before that damn commercial. That was the worst. Okay, so I got this. Yeah, that's better. I just didn't want it to have it so open there. And for some reason, one of these pockets came out just a little deeper than the other. But we're good to go. Alrighty, you guys, it's composition time. It's composition time. So pretty much this is how this is going to go. I'm going to go ahead and start, I'm going to glue this part in. And the flaps is pretty much, these outer flaps is pretty much the last thing that you do, that you glue on. The first thing that you want to glue on is make sure that your stuff is in its place. And I want to leave them sticking out just a smidge. So I'm going to leave the pocket itself popping out just a little bit. And you are good to go. Yeah, we learned. We learned, all right. We learned mama don't play. Mama don't play and shit fly in a heartbeat. And oops on the part. You didn't hear that. Make believe you didn't hear that. I'm gonna have to put a censor warning on my videos. Oh, Lord. All right, you guys. So I'm gonna try to keep them about the same on both ends. If you want these to be precise, then measure them beforehand. You know, make your little lines or whatever beforehand. I'm just kind of balling this out just a smidge. Kind of rounding this off a little bit. Rounding off some of these score lines so that I get more of a rounder shape. Just smoothing them out with my finger. You can do it with, you know, the tool if you want to. I don't know if you guys can hear my computer going off in the background. That's not vacuuming happening. That's my computer gasping for air. I have to replace it. It sounds like a jet engine trying to land. Alrighty, let's see. So we're almost there. We're almost there. We are almost there. Now to this side. It's so much fun hanging out with you guys. It's part of the allure of doing these live streams. It's coming to chill with you folk. Somehow, no matter where you were born at or raised at, our stories always somehow relate. Now to glue the other side. And I know this is harder for you guys to see it, but I'm only doing like a half a triangle kind of shape is where I'm going. So I'm going narrower towards the bottom and then just kind of widening it out a little bit towards the top. And then just trying to get it so that it falls in a natural place. And I think this one's actually going to be probably a little bit bigger than the first one that I made. Well, this is not the first one that I made. The first one that I made, it was from Maida. She got the first one that I made. I just started making these things. Hello, Susan. Thanks for joining. Like I said, you know what you want to do? You want to Google it, okay? So you want to Google what are the lines on a ruler, because that's pretty much what I did. I Googled what are the lines on a ruler. It's going to show you pictures. Get yourself a sticky note and do like what I did and just draw, write them all down, and you know that every single one of your little numbers is a line, and you just have to do it to an inch. You don't got to do it all the way across because they're just repetitive. Every inch repeats the same measurements over and over and over and over again. So just do it for the 1 inch and just write them all down and then just stick it on your board. Like, that's what I did. And behold, we almost have a purse. Now we're going to glue these down. But you know what? I'm thinking that I might want to cover this inside because it looks very cheap. So let's get some of this stuff covered up a little bit inside so that it look a little prettier. And I'm wondering if I should do it in black. I'm not so much worried about the white sides, but I am worried. Maybe I don't have to worry about that. Nah, that's not me. I gotta cover it. Let me just get a paper pad, you guys, and get some paper. If I can find some. What the heck I did with my paper pads? There we go. And then I gotta get this heat tool going so that I can glue on some embellishments. And let me see if I got one here that will go decent. I'm gonna use this wood one here. Might as well. What you want to know, girl? I'll go over it real quick for you. Yeah, I'm going to leave the measurements in the description box, but if you want to write them down real quick, I'll show them to you again. You want to grab a 12 by 12 sheet, and your first measurements are going to be 3 1/4 by 8 3/4, all the way from top to bottom on one side. Then you're going to rotate that paper sideways. And your next measurements are going to be 3 1/4, 4 1/2, 7 1/2, and then 11 1/4. And that pretty much is the score lines for the paper purse. The only other thing that you want to do, I kind of drew it for myself here, but once you have all your score lines in the four corners, right here is going to be your quarter inch. You know, this little part here that folds over is going to be right along the top and right along the bottom. So what you want to do is you want to pretty much cut just to that score line, cut to that score line, cut to that score line, cut to that score line, fold the tabs in half, cut again on all four of them so that you have like this kind of, it wants to look kind of like an H, but not all the way an H. It's kind of odd. But if anything, you could go back in the video and see it. You didn't even catch it? Bueno. What are we going to do? We're going to have to keep moving though. I'm definitely gonna have the measurements in the description down below. So pretty much where I'm at now is I'm gonna try to kind of cover up some of the stuff on the inside. So I am going to, let's see here. Is this about right? I need a little bit more, about a quarter inch, about an inch or so more. There we go. And let me cut off these corners here because I don't need them so much since my pockets are kind of interfering in that corner anyway. And then once I fold this flap over, we're good to go. See what I did. And I cut that one too short. Dang it. Oh well. It's gonna have to go like that. It's gonna have to go like that. Where's the other piece? Yeah, because this is too short. subscription. Description. Not subscription. Description. So, let's see here. So, I'm pretty much cutting both ends about the same. I'm just trying to cover up most of that white area in there. Since this purse was mainly black, then I just used black cardstock and covered the inside. But since this one's all white on the inside, makes it a little bit more, not difficult, but it definitely makes it a little bit more different for me to cover that. And I'm just going to cut off these corners because of the pockets, the way that they are and they push in. It kind of cuts off my access to those corners in the bottom. And this is still a little too wide. So because of that, I am just kind of fidgeting around and trying to figure out which is the best way for this to fit in there nicely. And I'm 2 seconds away from just giving up. I've given up. This is not looking proper. I don't like how it looks, so I'll leave it white. When at first you don't succeed, you try again. And if you don't succeed, you give up. No, I'm just kidding. You keep trying. I'm just not going to do it today. You never give up. But in this case, call me defeat. Because I could probably hook it up after. And not waste so much time trying to hook it up now. Yes, of course it would, Didi. Of course it would. It would always be easier to do it beforehand. But since I didn't think about it, this is one time that being impromptu works against me. I should have definitely done this first. Or even better yet, use double-sided paper. Hello. That would have made life easier all the way around. Yes, it would. Dang, cardstock paper. So, this is the price I have to pay now for not using double-sided paper, which I have, by the way. I don't have a lot, but I have some. I could have definitely done that. Save myself the aggravation. But oh well, all's well that ends well. So here we have pretty much our paper purse construction. Now we're going to decorate it. I need to measure out a strap for this. We are going to decorate all of these little loose ends. I'm going to get some ink and ink some of this stuff up. Just because I don't like it looking all pale. It's good for some things, but not for all things. And leave it like that. And we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Thank you. Hopefully it'll look even better once it's all done. I loved how this one came out. This is like my favorite. So much so, I don't even know if I'm going to give it away or not. I'm just in love with it. Black and gold just looks awesome together. So, I don't know. We'll see, Carmen. We'll see. We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. So now I'm going to cut some strips out. I got to see because I got to put the handles for this is going to go somewhere along here. So I'm going to cut the handles off first, put those on first before I even go to the next step and do anything else with that. Because I need to make sure that those handles are in the right spot. And I got to heat up my glue gun. Otherwise, I'm going to be holding that thing still forever. And we don't want that. And my glue gun blew up, you guys. Oh my God. I was so scared yesterday. This thing started smoking. It started throwing sparks. I was like, what? And I wasn't even done. I was working on this friendship umbrella here, and I still had to do this bottom part, like add all these little beads and stuff to that. I didn't have this glued to this. I didn't have the word love glued on. I didn't have my handle on. All I had was like the base of the umbrella and all the little flower stuff. I was missing pretty much a good maybe 30% of the project to be complete. And my freaking glue gun caught on fire. I had to like run to the store today and go get me this chippy chopper one, but it'll do the job for now. I was scared. And more so because since I paint and stuff, I always have water on my desk. Because I have to clean my brushes and everything. So I was like, oh my god, thank god that thing was not like near my bucket of water. Oh god, I don't even know what woulda, coulda, shoulda, woulda. But I know something woulda happened. Thank you. Yes, it's the friendship umbrella that everybody's making. I'm going to be including some handmade items into my giveaway. So between purses and umbrellas, somebody's going to get somebody something different. But I don't know yet exactly who's going to get what. Or if it's even going to be anything that I have already made. I'll probably make something. I'm not even sure. But I'm definitely going to give away some handcrafted stuff. Plus, I like to paint. So chances are is that somebody is going to get some hand painted something by me. Brandy's is almost done. And her hand painted item, well, her... the canvas that I made the other day on live, she won that, and that is going to be on its way beginning of the week. So I've cut out two two-inch strips of paper, which I have to score, okay, in order, and then they're going to get folded out like this, more or less. So you want to score them so you're not exposing all this white in the background. And then with the remainder of the paper, I am going to most likely get my my strap out of this to make everything match, and then whatever's left over, we'll figure it out. I just want to make sure that my paper is exactly the same size, and it is not. Don't you just love that when you put your paper in the score, in the cutting thing, and it still doesn't cut it like it needs to cut it? It's like off angle, but I could understand because my cutting board is like a conjunction of two different cutting boards. It's got the blade of one cutting board, which I don't have because I ordered a blade and they sent me that one. And I returned it, and they sent me the same thing again, so I gave up. And I pretty much made it work. I hot glued it to this little piece of plastic. And that's what I used to cut, to trim my paper now. So, yeah. The nightmares of a New York crafter. They lucky I watched a lot of MacGyver when I was little, so I always find a way to fix something. You've seen one what? A friendship umbrella? Yeah, it's like the worst. Like, what is the point of the paper cutter if you're never going to be able to cut in a straight line? Like, hello. Somebody help me with that, please. Yeah, and it cut a hairline short of 2 inches, which is what I was going for, because then it would have made my measurements more or less precise, but it didn't do that. So, I'm going to score at one line before the two, and hopefully that'll help me level the playing field out. And I'm just going to score this right down the middle. And another thing that I'm, like, having such a pet peeve with is this paper cracking. Like, don't these people know that we're going to be using this to cut and to fold and to score and to stick on stuff? Like, why is the paper cracking? Hello. Look at this. And I still did it wrong, but oh well. It's going like that. So I'm just going to trim off that excess that I got there. But look at this, you guys. Crack, 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 crack. So I'll figure it out, though. I'll probably add some beading or something to that crack there, or I'll shade it in. Usually what I do is I grab the ink and I just whoop, whoop, make it look like vintage leather. Oh, wow. You good now, though, right? This thing, my computer does the same thing. It'll tell me that I'm out of memory out of nowhere. And I'm like, what you mean I'm out of, like, memory? Like, what? And it'll literally go white. I don't know if this happens to you guys. I used to have Time Warner before, and that never happened to me. I got Verizon now, and I keep going through this situation where my screen whites out, and it says that I'm out of memory. But that never happened to me until I got Verizon. So I don't know if it's a Verizon thing or if that's just now or what the heck is going on. So I'm going to cut off all this excess and then I'm going to glue this whole strip. And you want to glue it and you want to kind of curl it at the same time so you start getting that nice bend. So let me cut this off first. And hopefully this will do its thing. But like, yeah, it's such a pet peeve of mine with this paper. Because like the paper pads are like $20, sometimes more. And then you fold it and it cracks. Like, what? They add so much stuff to them, which, I mean, the paper's beautiful. Don't get me wrong. It's eye candy, and most of us will buy it because it shines and it glistens and all of that stuff. But the minute that you try to make something with it, if you're not going to glue a flat surface onto flat surface, like, it's done. It takes all the beauty out of it because your paper now is torn, and it is all crinkly and looks sad. Okay. So I got my strips, now I'm going to glue, and I don't like using hot glue for this. You can if you want to, but I don't like the bumps of the hot glue on my stuff, so I normally try to use as much wet glue whenever possible as I can, and you guys know me, I use the Dollar Tree embellishing glue. That is my go-to glue. It is like a lifesaver for me, and I glue everything in its mother with this glue, and it sticks and it dries clear, so I love it. So I think I got enough of that on there. So pretty much I'm just gonna apply some pressure, and as I do it, I'm gonna go, I don't know if you guys can see me, but I'm actually making a bend as it's gluing, you know, as it's drying. I'm smoothing out the wrinkles as I go. But at the same time, I'm also kind of curling this thing out so that it's a little bit more flexible for when I try to curl it and glue it on as a strap. Don't download anything online unless it's from a trusted site. What happened? I missed a whole bunch of stuff here. Okay, let's see. Marobites is a good program. You can use it. Yes, I remember, who was it, Didi, was it you that had the problem with the computer? Malwarebytes is good to track and find stuff, but you know what stuff is good too? Spybot. Spybot is free. It's a deeper cleaning program, but it is free, and it gets rid of everything that is malware, virus. It gets rid of all of that stuff. So, like, if you run your Malwarebytes and you finish with that and you run your Spybot, chances are the Spybot is going to pick up anything else that's left over. The only thing with Spybot is that it does take a longer time to search through. So, like, I would say that you run that, like, when you go to bed and leave it running on your computer. Because chances are that if it's your first time running it, it's going to take a really long time to clean. No, you don't buy it at the store. You download it. You download the free version. They usually have a free version of Malwarebytes. And it will expire, but you'll still be able to run it for free. You just won't get none of the newer stuff. But you still can use it on your computer, even though it says, you know, expired or whatever. You still can run the malware. It'll still catch stuff. You can still go to your chest and delete it and throw it, you know, and empty it out. And it'll still catch stuff. So, I mean, you don't necessarily have to go with the paid version if you don't want to. Yes, they do. They do have a free version for Malwarebytes. Yes, they do. So if you're worried, like I said, if you're worried about that, download the Malwarebytes, but also look for SpyBot. It's one word. And download that as well. It will take longer to scan and clean, but it is an awesome program, and it has saved my computers more than once from stuff. So you might want to try that. And if and whenever possible, and you can run a boot time scan, which pretty much means that it'll check your computer while your computer, when your computer's restarting, like it'll automatically go into that black screen, kind of like that DOS screen, which is black with the white letterings, and it'll start scanning through there. That is the best time to have your computer scanned, because since nothing is running in the background, nothing is activated, it has access to every single file and folder, and it can usually get most of the crap out. Yeah, it's okay if it's expired, Didi. You can keep running it. And keep updating it. When it tells you update the database, keep updating it. Well, a little bit. I didn't get to finish the schooling or anything like that, but I learned enough to keep me going. You're talking about the dark one? Or the Wonder Woman one. This one is it's a religious bracelet. It has a saint on it, and this one has the pull knots that you can pull through it, and it has the double threaded. It's kind of looped around so you can pull them, and it has the same thing on the top and the bottom. The other one is just like a regular Wonder Woman, bracelet. Okay, I think I fiddled enough with that band there. But you guys can see how it kind of naturally starts curving. So now when I cut off, round off these corners here, and I go to put it, it'll more easily be in a good position for me to be able to glue these down without having too much of an issue. So when I go to add it in this way, or this way, depending on which way you want it. If you want it to stick out or you want it to stick in, you know, it all depends on how you want it. Depending on the fold, depending on the way that, it'll either buckle in. If you fold it in the other way, it'll buckle out. So, I got that one in there. I try. I'm always trying to do the little bit that I can wherever I can. So, I saw you was in trouble, and I knew that was something that I knew about. I might not have known what was going on exactly, but I can always at least refer you to where you could get the information from when it's relating to that. I sometimes see so many computers being thrown out in the street, and I'm like, oh my God, how can people throw them out? And it's usually like the dumbest thing, like the fan went out or the screen went blank. Like, hello, there's replacement parts for all that stuff. And it's sometimes the easiest stuff to replace. Like, don't throw your stuff out. And don't listen to repair people. I'm sorry to tell you guys, but that is like the biggest scam. They will tell you that it's so expensive. Whenever you find out what's wrong with your computer, order the piece yourself and go with the piece. Because they're going to charge you 3 times as much just for the piece alone. And on time, it usually doesn't take that long to put a piece in. And that's for any piece of a computer. It does not take that long to put a piece in. It'll take some time, you know, because there's a lot of bolts and there's a lot of layers sometimes, depending on where exactly the piece is located. But usually all the major components are put in the top. The only things that are put all the way in the bottom are usually fan related or battery related or something of that nature. You know, where the power comes from. But for the most part, everything that you can change that is usually what the reason why your computer is acting up in the first place is put right on the top layer. So don't get fooled. If they tell you something's wrong with them, ask them what. And when they tell you what it is, then order the piece yourself online. Go to eBay, find the piece number for your computer, order it, and then take it to them and be like, okay, fix it. How much is it going to be now? Yeah. I can't wait to send it to you. Like, it's almost done. I just have to finish painting off the back and stuff. And then it'll be ready for packaging, and off to you it'll go. Okay, you guys, so I think this is pretty much glued in. I'm just making sure that I don't have no little openings here, you know, or anywhere for that matter, because we don't want that buckling and we don't want that opening for it to start kind of breaking through there. I'm very particular when it comes to that stuff. So, thank God for this little tight nozzle. It lets me get into all the little nooks and crannies that normally I can't get into. And we'll be good to go. And we'll be able to, my glue gun's been heating. That's another reason I've been taking my time. Because since it's new, it does take a little longer to heat up. I'm going to darken up my edges on both sides and get this show crack-a-lacking. And we'll be decorating soon. No, you didn't. Brandy did. Miss Left-Handed Crafter. Hi, Janet. Thanks for joining. So I'm just going to darken up these edges because all this broken paper makes me sad. And I don't want to be sad, so I got to cover it up. I gotta cover it up with something. Cause me no likey. Such pretty paper. Gone kaput. And let's see. And I need glue over here. And anywhere I find these little openings, I'm going to glue them in because, like I said, it just, I don't like it popping open. And when I make something for somebody, I want it to last. And there's nothing worse than sitting there looking at what you received and finding all the defects. Which, I don't do that, by the way, but I think about that. I think that they're going to do that, so I always kind of look over. That's just how self-conscious I am. So I always gotta go over things once or twice or sometimes three times just to make sure that it's like, okay, I would hang this on my wall, or I would definitely put this on my desk, or, you know, I could give this forward to somebody, because I know sometimes it's hard to keep everything that everybody gives you. And eventually some things get turned into hand-me-downs and they get shifted around a little bit. Which is fine with me. It's still sharing. Sharing is caring. So I am A-okay with that. So there we go. So now what are we going to do? Okay. I gotta round off some of these corners here. Oh, let's see if I can do it this way. Didn't let me do it. Okay. My corner rounder doesn't round corners anymore. It only smashes them. So I gotta freehand this now. And this one, it only works when the paper is of a certain size. So I am trying to at least get the shape of it so that I can just follow along and hopefully get this right. So, doing things the hard way today. And I almost had to cancel because, like I said, my glue gun burned out. So, I'm like, oh my God, I gotta do a paper purse. Like, how am I gonna do this thing without a glue gun? Like, I need a glue gun. So, luckily, my pharmacy had one. And I was able to save the day like that. So, yeah. I have a circle punch, but wouldn't it do it concave? Like, wouldn't it do it in a way that the circle is in as opposed to out? Or wouldn't it take out the whole, like, I don't know. I have a few of them, actually. I have a few circle punches. I never thought to do that because I always thought that it was going to make the... It was going to take out like a half a moon type shape as opposed to curling it up for me like I wanted it to. All right, you guys, I think that these straps are done. And this would have been done a long time ago, but I just love talking to you guys. So I'm taking my time. So the straps are going to go here, right? And once the strap's in, then everything else is easy because now you know where your placements of everything is. I forgot to darken this edge up, so let me do that real quick. And I need a glue stick, or hello, this glue gun's not going to work. And I grab a glitter one. Hello, Carmen. Pay attention. I'm going to take out a few of them because I have a feeling I'm going to be needing a few of them. And I do not like this glue gun, but it'll do because it just drools like a baby. And it does not stop drooling all the glue. So here we go. Point of no return. Collecting off some of this glue as I go. And then the other one's gonna go here. And I like the fact that all of them are always different. Every single purse that I've made so far, which has only been a total of two, they always look different. Even though you start off with the same design, you know, with the same template, if you will. They always come out looking different. And I love that about these things. So I'm pressing it in nice and tight because I do want to get some of that excess glue off. I do not want this thing bulging out like crazy. And this is the best time to kind of get some of that glue off as well. It's still kind of soft. You can pretty much roll it right off with your fingers while it's still soft. So it's the best time to do it. So we have our very first handle, ladies and gentlemen. Give yourselves a pat on the back. We've made it so far. Bye, Dee Dee. Thanks for joining, girl. Thank you. Enjoyed having you here today. It was a ton of laughs. So here I go, adding my next one. And I'm doing this right on the edge, you guys. But you can put your straps wherever you want. They don't have to be put on the edge of anything. You could put them right on the center. You could just put one if you want. Like, styling is infinite. And we're gonna do the next one. This thing is like an industrial freaking glue gun. Like, oh my god. So much glue comes out of it with like the smallest little squeeze. Spending all my money. All my glue sticks. Okay. So we have our little purse so far. Very sturdy. I just had to show you guys. It's very sturdy so far for being made of paper. This style is very strong, especially when you have paper that is somewhat like a cardstock. Once everything is all glued into place, it reinforces everything, and it just makes everything that much stronger. The straps are 12 inches across, as you saw, 12 by 2 inches, folded in half. And then we have that. Now I have my measurements. Now I know that I have this much space, pretty much add my strap in the center. And I can add my pockets to the outside. I've already added some pockets here. And once I've done that, then I'll decorate it. I'll leave the decorating for last. So, let's see here. So I need about an inch and a half off of this paper here. So let's see if I'm going to pull this glue stick out of there so it doesn't just throw my money out the window. Because like I said, it's a drooling baby. This is how many inches? This is about 4 inches. So let's make this 3. Let's make this 3 inches a nice wide. And see how this goes, how this fits in the center here. I like the buckle to be nice and wide. I wanted to take up most of that space in the center. So this is about 3 inches. Since I put the little handles all the way off on the far ends of each other, I have about 3 inches. And I usually put my strap so that it goes from the very bottom up. That way it doesn't fall off midway or mid-travel or from opening and closing it. And I still have a piece here that I can use for anything else. I want to, but I won't be using that for now. And I'm probably gonna have to cut off a little bit of this, but I'm gonna see how much right now. Actually, I won't need to cut off anything, so the whole strip of 12 inches is more than enough. And I'm gonna round off these corners here, and I'm thinking I'm gonna add something in the center of this belt to just embellish it a little bit. So I'm gonna go and see. I'm not going to round off the corners because I want those to be flush with the bottom of the belt itself. Did I get some glue here? I want this to be flush with the bottom of the belt. I mean, with the bottom of the purse. And then this is going to get tucked into a pocket that I'm going to create here. There's going to be specifically for the buckle itself. And then I'll make a pocket inside of a pocket in case I want to make something on the outside of that. And I'll add a pocket to the back here so that in case you want to add any goodies to the back. And then it has a pretty good size. I mean, you can fill this up a very nice ways. And when it's properly decorated in the inside, you know, it's a different story. It's turning out really cute. Thank you, Debbie. You should make one, Sherry. What is your name? Sherry? Should I call you Sherry? It's not that many measurements. As long as you know this much, that your bottom of your base, pretty much you want it to be. I try to simplify myself, like how I process things. So you know that the bottom of your base, you want it to be at least 3 inches by 5.5. If you can get yourself a nice square that's 3 inches by 5.5 in the middle of your 12 by 12 paper, you've done pretty much all of the measurements right there. I know it's easier said than done, but there are easier ways of doing this than this. I just followed somebody's tutorial, which is why I just felt that that way was a little bit more sturdier. The ones that I was making when the paper purses first started coming out, the ones that I was making weren't as pretty as this in the sense of the style. Mine's were more squarish. They almost looked more like bags, like shopping bags, if you will. I gotta get myself a piece of paper so that I can add some kind of an adornment to the center of that. So give me 1 second, you guys, while I try to find myself a piece of paper that I can use. And I might as well use the same kind of paper from the same paper line. And in case I didn't show you guys, what I'm using is this one, the French Country Stack by DCWV. This is pretty much the paper line that I used to make this. And I'm just going to grab a paper in the same design as the bag itself. And I'm going to use a punch, and I'm going to make a nice little border strip. And I'm going to glue that onto the belt. So that at least there's some contrast there. And then I'll use some of the pieces that are left over. I'll use some of this and some of this to create some of the pockets, and I think that that'll be pretty good. So I have this really huge Martha Stewart punch. So I'm just going to go ahead and make me a whole line of this, since the paper itself is 12 inches. I have to see what I'm doing. I know some, you know, most people use this thing without having to flip it over, but I do. Because otherwise, I'll end up cutting sections instead of cutting what I need to cut, which is one continuous band. So I do this way. So don't mind my concentration over here. It's an awesome paper stack. I love it. It has so many different flowery patterns. And I just love flower patterns and vintage stuff. Almost there, you guys. The last little bit right here. And what a mess. All that to get one band. Now let me pick up my messes, because this is going to drive me crazy if I don't clean it up. It's funny how I could be messy when I do paint, but now when I do paper crafts, like, that would drive me nuts. It's like my mind switches mode. It goes from one way of thinking to something completely different. Okay, so I have my band here. And I'm just going to cut off these little tidbits here. So as you guys can see, very pretty. I love this punch. I'm glad you are, Sherry. That's what it's about. It's about the pure enjoyment of it all. So I'm going to go ahead and glue this into place from top to bottom, right down the center. At least what I hope is the center, right? So that at least my buckle has some kind of a style to it and it's not so plain Jane. And we're going to figure this out. We're going to figure this out. So you know what? I might as well just do it to this, because that'll be just crazy of me to try to actually go around every one of those little nooks and crannies on that strip of paper. Like, that would take me like a whole another 3 hours of live stream just to glue around that whole pattern. So This is just easier, and this glue dries clear, so no harm there. And this paper is already kind of texturized as it is. It's got like that clear kind of coating that they put on it. My biggest thing is to make sure that this is straight. And I'm just doing this because I know for, you know, since it's going to be curling back and forth in order to go into the buckle itself, mm-hmm. I want to make sure that everything here... More to tell me. Oh, Dios mío. This is so funny. I just want to make sure that wherever it will lift up, that I got it nice and tacked down. Because since I know, like I said, I'm going to be moving this up and down, I want to make sure that everything is in a good position and is glued well. So I'm not having any bad accidents. Yes, the best part is always the decorating. I think I do all these things just so that I can embellish them. So we're almost there. Let me darken up my edges, you guys. Let me darken up my edges. So everything matches. We want everything to match. So let's see. So since this is the same pattern, it doesn't really matter which side I put the buckle to go into or come out of, because this, you know, is a universal pattern. It goes all the way around. So my biggest thing is just going to be to make sure that I glue this in properly. And again, I'm not using hot glue for this because I don't want it to dry bumpy. I want it to dry nice and smooth, and I don't want it to stick out like it's dimensional. I just want to make sure that it's nice and smooth and all in line. And since this glue is awesome, it dries it up to perfection. And I don't have to go crazy worrying about it coming off later on. My biggest thing is going to probably be to just hold it in place for a few minutes or seconds. Only because this paper itself has that waxy stuff on it. So let's see here. Again, trying to put this so that it's somewhat centered. And I want this to be flush with the baseline of this purse. And just holding it in place for a few. In what? In the purses? It depends what it's for. Like, if it's like going into Happy Mail, which is like the one that I get before, then anything that is small, like small stamps, small things, I'll put in here. Like, I know that the one that Myra gave me, she put in like anything that was purse related. So she put in lip gloss. She put a little compact mirror in there. Her mind went straight into, okay, this is what a purse is for, which was super cute when I opened it and I found all these little purse-related things. Napkins, you know, like it all depends. You can fill it in, like if it's an actual purse and like what you would want to find in your purse. So you can add like lipsticks, lip gloss, like I said. She put a little compact mirror in there, which was so cute. Or you can just fill it up with small items, little handmade things, like little stamps, little ink pads, just little handmade items. Wow. Wow, Linda, you're snowed in. Where are you at? Where are you? Our snow wasn't too bad, thank God. It came, but it went quickly. So this is pretty much it for me and the gluing, as far as this buckle, and it's already in line. And as you guys can already see, it already gave the purse life. It completely transformed it from something plain and Jane to something that has a little bit more pizzazz. It has a lot more style to it. It's already coming all together. Normally, under normal circumstances, I would definitely would recommend that you either use a double-sided paper for making your purse, A. Or number two, put a different a cardstock or a different paper. Cut the strips down if you need to, you know, measure it out and cut the strips down if you need to. And just cover the inside of this and the inside of that. Like what I did with this one, I used black cardstock and the strap itself. I made this smaller and then I just, you know, enforced it. I put it as a backing and I just put black cardstock on the back of that. And then on the inside, I also used black cardstock to make the pocket and to just cover it up on the inside. It just looks a lot more cleaner. If you're going to be giving it to somebody, chances are that once I'm off camera, because I know me, I won't be able to rest until this is the way I want it to be. So chances are that I will be decorating this in the inside. I will be covering it up some way, somehow. I'll figure it out, a way to actually decorate it. And if I can't decorate it, I'm going to paint it, because there's just no way, no how, that this is going to go to somebody looking like this. My whole thing of this today with you guys was to pretty much show you that it's not as difficult. It's actually pretty simple. Maybe I didn't do the best job at simplifying it for you, because I added so many extra, you know, elements to it, if you will. But it's really simple to make. Once you get that template down packed, it's real simple. All of this pocket stuff is extra. You don't have to do all this pocket stuff. You know, this is just extra stuff. So this is drying, and I'm going to leave this be. I'm going to go ahead and start cutting out some pockets that I'm going to be placing here. And then I have to measure my buckle size so that I can add a perfect pocket for my buckle to go into, so that it's nice and clean. And then all you have to do is pretty much pull it up to put it, you know, to take it out, and then slide it back in. And then everything is nice and tucked away. Norway. Wow. Norway is far from New York. Thank you. I appreciate that, Sherry. So I'm going to cut some papers. We're going to cut some papers, you guys. I love doing all different kinds of accents. It's actually something I do in the house pretty much all day, every day. My kids think that I'm halfway nuts, but when I don't do it, then they're like, okay, something's wrong with mom, and then they're all worried. So they're kind of used to my zaniness, but I'm actually a little bit more than this on a regular. I try to find ways to laugh all day, every day. I think life is not worth living if you can't find something that makes you happy. So I try to find something that makes me happy every day. Every day. Let's see here. I'm going to cut about there. I'm just eyeballing it for now. But you can always get precise if you want. If you want to. I overstepped it, but that's okay. I'm checking both ends because you know that my paper cut is retarded. It's like a Frankenstein. It's made of different parts. So it doesn't cut even all the time. So I have to check. I'm going to cut another strip just for good measure, but I'm going to cut it shorter. So I see more or less how much I overcut on this one. So I'm going to cut this one a little shorter. Just a little shorter. Made my little mark there. So this one's gonna be a little bit less than 3 inches. I probably should have made about 3 inches, but a little less than 3 inches. And let's see what happens. Perfección. Perfect, perfect. Just what I wanted. Okay. So I switched to my smaller one. trying to see, because some of these corners are going to get folded over. So about there. So this is about perfect right there. And then again, I'm probably going to do the same thing with the strip and cut the whole strip out. And then I'll be able to add some of that strip so that everything kind of matches, but in opposite. Yes, it is. And I try to laugh all day, every day. I know it annoys the heck out of people that I'm always so happy, but you got to be happy. You have to. You have to find the reason. You have to find the way. Because sadness is just, it's just sad. So why give it all that power? No. You can't give it all that power. Forgot what I was doing. There we go. You can't give it all that power, you guys. You gotta find a way. There's gotta be something every day that makes you laugh. There's gotta be something, even if you have to go back in time mentally and think about something at one time or another that made you smile. There's gotta be something. There's always something that makes you happy. That just the sheer thought of it brings a smile to your face. Let that be your focus point. You can do it. Okay, I will. Don't worry, I still got a little ways to go. So let's see. So this is too wide, so I'm going to put this in my back pocket. So I'm going to add this here. This is going to be part of my back pocket. The only thing I'm going to do now is that I'm going to cut up some of the strip here. Or I'm thinking I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to use this strip instead. Just to give it a little bit more oomph. Plus this one's a little lighter and it's a lot easier to handle. And I'm going to use it to add borders to my pockets. So that I have a nice little border on the top of all my pockets. Yeah, it's coming together, girl. We're almost there. We are almost there. We are almost there. Two hours in the making. Just getting rid of some of those little thingamabobs that stick behind. And I'm actually going to cut this strip down a little bit. Because it's a little too wide for my taste. I'm going to cut this down. I'm going to cut this down. Let's just see. You guys know my paper trimmer is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, right? So I'm just hoping it did an even job. It looks even, but I don't know. I don't know. So this is pretty much how this is gonna go. Right along the top there. On both of them. So let's get this pocket glued in. Before I do that, I have to score one more time because I forgot to make the bottom section that also needs to fold over. And I am now overwhelmed with glue and little bits and pieces. So all we're going to do to this is just pretty much cut the corners off so we have a flush pocket. You just cut the bottom corners off so you can fold your pocket inward like this. So that at least your pocket has a little bit of room in case you want to add something cute. Yes, they're awesome and they're so addicting. I find so many crafts that I just, once that I start doing them, I don't know, I can't stop. I start feeling a little crazy and I'm like, oh my God, I gotta make one. And my mind starts like a flash of all different ideas and styles. And I start watching these movies, these crafty little movies, where everything is just like flashing. It's almost like a runway show. And I see all these different styles and ideas. It's unfortunate, I never write them down fast enough. And when I write them down, I never find where I wrote them. I forgot to ink this, so before I put this down, I'm just gonna ink this real quick. Just to make sure that it's nicely inked. And yes, I am gonna glue it down before I go ahead and add the trim to it. I'm gonna add the trim after the fact. First thing I wanna do is make sure that I got this in here nice. So I'm just gonna hold this in place for a few while my glue decides to work with me. Don't you just love it? Our minds, oh my God. It's always pulling us in one direction or another. I have to try at least everything I see once. At least once. I got the friendship umbrella out of my system. I finally did that one. The video's gonna be coming up. I just have to edit it. I already got it uploaded and converted and everything. I just have to edit it. So I'll have that up on my channel soon. Hopefully by tonight, if not tomorrow, of how I did this, the umbrella. Just don't expect to hear actual instructions as more of just watching me do it, because like I said, this is why I do these lives, because it's just easier for me to show you guys and talk you through it as I'm doing it, and also get the feedback from you. So if you guys have any questions, then doing the tutorials themselves, it just complicates my life a little bit. So I'll either write them into the video, or you'll just end up watching me create the whole process of how I did it. And we still have more embellishment to do, because I'm going to be adding some little pearls here along the edges and just making this a little bit extra cuter. My pocket is pretty much good to go. I'm going to go ahead and add my strip of paper here. Just making sure that I got this in the right spot. And I am going to ink this up like everything else, just to make everything pop. I'll show you guys more or less what I'm doing. So I'm just inking up as much of the ink as it's gonna take. I'm not gonna go too crazy with trying to ink this thing up. Then I'm gonna glue it and stick it, and that's it. No, I'm not finished. I still have one more part. I still have the buckle in the front to do, which is where the strap is going to go into. Right now, I'm just adding. I made the pocket and I added that. And I'm just adding the little trim to it so that it doesn't look so plain Jane. And just adding little bits of glue here and there to the actual borders of this thing, so that it all sticks down and it's not getting caught on anything. I gotta fix my bottle because it's throwing up glue. Whoop! And it went flying. It went flying, which pretty much tells me, hurry up, Carmen, I think you're done. Somebody's anxious. So, let's get this on here. Let's slide this bad boy into place while we still can. Looking a lot better already, right, guys? Just rubbing this into place. So we have our nice little deep pocket in there that we can add anything into. It's nicely adorned. We got a little lip here. Nothing too major, but I don't want to see it with a lip. Just gonna get a little bit of that ink in there. So that's that side. And while my glue gun is still hot, I'm gonna add some beading to this. And I found some pink. I just don't ever have enough. I don't think I have enough. That's all the pink beading I have. So it'll have to be this one here. This pearlescent one. I'm just gonna cut myself some and work off of that. Hopefully it's more than enough than what I need. So I'm thinking something along the edges here. No. Something along the edges, like right there. What do you guys think? Like right there? Or should I do it along the bottom? Should I do it along the sides? I just feel like it needs something. Or maybe I should put it right there. I kind of like that. With it right there over the... over that. So I'm thinking I'm gonna put it right there, you guys. Let me put this glue back in. Ugh. Come on. This thing was just dying to throw up. What I have to get, some of that clear glue sticks that people are using. I didn't even know they made that. And I'm gonna ever so gently put these into place. Come on, form a straight line for me. Ain't this about a... Just when I thought I was out, he pulls me back in. I don't like that messy glue look. I try so hard to avoid that messy glue look. And it is not working with me today. Let's go. Let's go there, buddy. Alright, we did it. Now we need something there. What do I have here? Do I have any flowers? Anything close by? I have 3 little white roses left. Let's see what we can do with these. I gotta order more from eBay. I'm like out. My stash is done. Oh, you're lucky. High 70s. It's in the high 7s over here. Okay, I like that. I like that. No, I can't use those. I should have used those. I got a whole bunch of those. Here I am with the white ones. And this one's a beige one. This one don't even match right now. And I got another one that flew somewhere south. I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. I'm in New York, folks. In the middle parts. Okay. Let's see here. Added some white roses. What do you guys think? With the little white roses. Should I add some more trim to this? I definitely gotta add the trims on the side. So this is gonna go something like this. And all the way around. New York. Yeah, baby. I'm a New Yorker. Okay, so let's see here. Let's get some of this beading on. This here. Just try to get some of this beadwork in. This glue is, it's not working with me. I don't like this glue gun. I think it knows it too. Because it's giving me attitude. And it's not sticking the way I want it to. Thank you. I'm trying. I never really know how things are going to come out till they're done. This whole thing I have against planning. And I'm trying to be a planner, and I have a thing against planning. Isn't that funny? But I think that's probably why I want to get into planning, because I need to get my ideas in line. Because sometimes I'm not cooperating with myself. Okay. This glue sucks. Stupid glue. I never thought I'd see the day that I would buy a pack of glue sticks and it'd be garbage. Wow, you're fart. But I guess that's the point of YouTube. Connecting minds from all across the globe. I always wanted to go to New Mexico. Truth be told, I always wanted to go somewhere else other than New York. I've been to Florida once. I've been to Washington, D.C. once when I was young. That's it. There goes my adventures. Oh, and I've been to Dominican Republic because I'm Dominican, so I've been there a few times when I was little, but I haven't been there in years. That's probably why my Spanish is so off. I haven't visited the motherland to refresh the vocabulary. And with my husband being Puerto Rican, I got all kinds of Spanish stuff just going through here. Okay. I'm hoping. Yeah, this glue came with this gun, and ugh. It is bad. Bad, man. So here we go with that. And since I can't stick none of those other flowers on there, I think I'm going to have to add these little flowers that I got there. And just add these in here. Because I like covering the little ends of the pearls. I like covering that. So I'm probably going to put a little flower on each one of those ends just to cover that up a little bit. Oh, you're in Florida. That's right, you are, right? I just sent something to you over there. So we're almost done. I'm eventually going to cover these little end caps over here, like I like to call them. And I'm going to add probably some lace or something here to the top of that. But we'll see what happens. I'm going to make my strap end now. And again, this paper's too much. This paper's too much. So what I'm going to do, this is pretty much what I do. Because I want this to fit snug in there. I don't want it to dance around, otherwise it's going to pop out. So what I like to do is pretty much draw where my straps actually go. And then I know more or less how big, how wide to cut it. And this drooling idiot over here, I gotta get me a better glue gun because I'm... Woosa, you're taking me away from my happy place. I need to buy a better glue gun. And I'm gonna trim this off a little bit because it's too wide. It's too high, actually. So I'm just going to take a little bit off the bottom just to kind of make this shorter. And I'm going to score where I made my markings. Hello, crafty girl, purple 62. Aw. How you feeling now? You still having a headache, girl? Hopefully you feel better soon. Hopefully you feel better soon. Did I do this correctly? We shall see. So I'm going to fold, 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 and fold. And then cut, 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 and cut. And make my little buckle. And I got some more trim that I'm going to be adding to this one as well. To finish off the look. Yes, headaches are the worst. Have you gone to a chiropractor? Those are usually good. When they know what they're doing, they're good. So you guys see how that works? Once I put this thing in here, it's nice and snug, and I'll be able to slide this in and out of that buckle there, and make it all look uniform. The thing here to do is pretty much glue, glue, glue. Well, before I glue, let me ink, ink, ink. Hi, Nola. Thanks for joining us. We've been here crafting away on this paper purse, getting ready to add the buckle element. Well, not the buckle, the pocket for the buckle. If my glue will cooperate. And then what I do is that I put it right on there. I put it right on there so that it's pretty much in perfect line with where I need it to be. And I'm gonna line this up with the bottom here, like I did the other pocket. And now that it's in line, I will take this out because I know more or less where I want this to be. Where is the natural position for this? And then I'll just hold that in there for a few minutes. Thank you, Nola. Well, hello from New York. Let's put this bad boy in there. And it pretty much slides right into place. Very easy. Easy as pie. Just put it right in there. And now you don't gotta go crazy with your buckles. You just slide it right in the front. And the front looks like the back. But I'm about to fix that with the thing. With the thingamabob. And that's pretty much it. Thank you. So now I'm just going to add this little trim here. Just making seeing where I need to cut. Sure over here before I glue this into place that I've got what I need. Yeah, just gotta level this off a little bit because that came off at a slight angle, and darken this up a little bit with some ink and we will be good to go. More, tú estás roncando en el video. More, tú estás roncando en el video, por favor. En vivo y en directo. Ya yo voy a terminar. Para que te acuestes tranquilo. Pero te estoy oyendo. Y yo sé que si yo te oigo, te oyen ellos también. Hoy te ganó el sueño. Okay, you guys, so I'm going to put this in. No take backsies from here. Make sure everything is in perfect line. And we are good to go. Just sliding it up into position here. Making sure everything is nice and stuck down. And while that is drying, making sure that it's not stuck to my buckle here, I'm going to go add the trim on the side, and we are about finito, you guys. We are about finito. We are about finito, yep. 2 hours. 2 hours, and I don't know how much changed, but 2 hours for sure. We've been here having the time of our life. I don't like this glue gun one bit. It's constantly throwing up. It got me out of a pinch. I'll give it that much. It's the only reason it doesn't go flying to the garbage can, because it saved me for now. But I definitely have to go invest into something that's a little bit more better than this. The strips of glue is just humongous. And when it's not in use, it's just constantly spitting the glue out. So for me now, cleaning this is a pain in the catoosh. Because just so much glue comes out of it. So hard right now. Such a pain in the bum bum. But we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Do they have glue guns that have like those really thin nozzles? So only a little bit of glue comes out at one time? Because that is something worth investing in right there. That is something worth investing in, I tell you. Look at this. Before I haven't even touched it, and the glue is coming out of it. And then it cools up so quickly. It barely gives you time to lay anything on it. I am just not a happy glue gun user right now. There's so much glue to clean up after. My other glue gun, I bought it at, what is it, Dollar General, I think I bought it. And it was way better than this. And that wasn't nothing out of this world either. That was just a regular old glue gun. This one, I don't know what the heck is wrong with it. It's like regurgitating glue left and right. So what else do we have to do? We have to add. I might have to bring my flower box out so that I can find some little flower roses to add to that. Detail tip. Yes. I need that. I need a glue gun with a detail tip. Because there's nothing, there's no detail in this one right here. Press the nozzle, don't press the nozzle. Like, it doesn't even matter. It don't even matter. Let me find some roses. Because I need to find some roses. So that I can put some flowers in there. I'm thinking about doing a live stream of making paper flowers. What do you guys think? Making all kinds of different paper flowers using the dyes. And also by hands with no dyes. What do you guys think of the idea? I found one. I need something. Something that brings a little bit of color to this whole thing. Situation here. Right there. Yes, Carmen, right there. I have one. Love it. This is the first time I'm envious of somebody. That's you, Sherry, because you have a detailed tip glue gun. Let's see. I got these other little white ones there. Let's see what we do with those. But yeah, I was thinking about making a video or something like a video. Well, like a live stream of doing like all different kinds of paper flowers, from smaller ones to bigger ones. Okay, I got four. That might be more than enough right there. Yeah, because I'm running out of flowers and I gotta make some. So I figured that might be something you guys might want to see, is how to make paper flowers without a dye, plus how to make them with a dye. And that way we kind of cover the whole kit and caboodle. Okay, this is not the white one. Okay, these two are the white ones. So what did I do? I put one on each corner there, so I'm going to put one on each corner here. And I just like to fold the little end cap, the little end wire down, and that way, look at this thing. This is so sad. It's ruining my happy moment, but I will not let it get me down. I will use you and I will love it. That's one. Yes, I'm thinking about doing a live, because that way if you guys have questions, then I can answer them. I think that that's easier than me doing a live stream, and then when it comes to the comments, then you guys are in the process of wanting to do them, and it won't have all your questions answered, because it'll take me time, you know, to get back and forth through the comments and stuff. Like this, I figured if I do it live, then I can show you both, like how to do them, you know, both ways, and then whatever you guys want to ask, you could just ask right there. And hopefully it'll help you out. And then that way, if you want to go back to it, then you'll have, you know, your questions will be answered through the tutorial. So it'll make it a lot easier. But I'm thinking about doing that. A whole bunch of making all different kinds of die cuts of flowers. And also showing you guys how to do them without, you know, needing a die. It's real simple to do them without needing a die too. But it does, it's a few steps you got to do to them to make them look more realistic. There's some things you gotta do to the paper itself, to give it that texture of real flowers, but they come out really nice. They come out really nice. Thank you. Yeah, it does give it like, it gives it more life. It makes it pop out a little bit. And I'm thinking, I don't know. I was thinking about adding some kind of lace there. Let me see what I have here. But I think it might be a bit too much. I do have this green, but nah, that's too much too. I love green, but I don't know. I don't know if this is gonna look right in there. I think I'm going to leave it like that, and I'm just going to add some more of the pearl trim and call it a day with that one, instead of adding that lace. So let me do that instead, and then I'll probably add one of these bigger white roses right to the center. Maybe yes, maybe no, maybe I'll just leave it with the trim. I think that might actually look good with just the trim in there. What do you guys think? Just the trim, right? Oh, yes. That's the purse that I gave to... Which one? This one? This black one? Or the other one? Because I posted one other one I think I gave that one to, wow, I didn't think. I gave that one to Myra through Happy Mail. I'm still trying to debate on what I want to do with those, with this purse and this purse that I'm making. Because you guys know I got that giveaway that I'm doing right now for my 1,000 followers. I'm almost there, you guys. I'm like at 990. So I'm like so super excited. And I'm definitely going to be giving away some handmade stuff. So I don't know if I just want to kind of leave it there for when I do that or what. But I'm not sure. I guess I'm going to leave that for people to let me know in the comments below after this video's up, like if you guys want this to be included in the giveaway, because I know a lot of you guys are participating, then let me know in the comments down below and I will make sure to either include it or not include it with the goodies that I'm already going to be giving out. Okay, open up. See, I should have done all this beforehand to try to do this now. It's a little bit of a pain in the, you guys know where, especially with this. Ugh. I don't like you. Oh my god, I don't like you. I've never had such a hard time. Look at this, the whole thing just comes right off. And this is a glue gun that's been on already for a while. Like, stop playing with me. You're gonna turn me back into the old me. Please. Please. I beg you, please work. Work. I am almost done. Don't mess up at the end. Please work. So I'm thinking like this. And then the last little bit of trim on this side. And then I think we're about done with this. So I am just going to cut this right about there because I think that's where it ends. And I'm gonna glue this on, you guys. So please let me know in the comments down below if this is something that you guys are gonna want included in the giveaway. And I'll make sure to either make one or give you one of the ones that I have. If you want this one, or if you want this black one, or if you want them both included, or if you want these two and a third one, because there's going to be a third prize, let me know. Or if you guys would rather have like one of these things, a friendship umbrella included in the giveaway with the prizes, then let me know as well. Because I would love to make something like that to include it in there. I think that would be super cool. I'm sorry, but it's got to listen. See, it's not spitting up no more because it listened to me. Like it knows. Stop playing with me. I guess me and this glue gun are going to have a conversation every day before I use it. Let her know who's the boss over here. And let it know that it could be turned into a recyclable. Stop playing. Look at this. Perfect job on this one. Ain't this about a... What's up, Carmen? Relax. You are one with the universe. Everything is wonderful. Everything is bliss. Life is beautiful. Enjoy. Smell the roses. We are done. We are done. Woohoo, ka-choo. We are done. But before we're done, I think I'm going to add roses, roses, roses. Because who doesn't like roses? But isn't that crazy? I yelled at it, and it worked. Oh, it thinks I'm playing games now, so it went right back to being its silly little self. I'm going to put a rose on each one of these little handles here. Just to finish off my pink and white rose scheme. Because the paper's all flowery with beautiful pink roses and flowers all over the place. So this would just be the perfect little accent to the purse. And then we shall be done for today, you guys. And then I just have to figure out what I'm going to do with the inside. And I'm going to open this one up as well. Make it nice and wide. And then voila. We are done. We did it. We did it, you guys. I survived. All right. I'm shutting this glue gun off. Thank you. Thank you. We are done. We are done. So, completed. I forgot what side it came off from. I'm pulling out the back. I'm like, shoot, I glued it in. Oh my God, I can't take it. Dios mio. So this comes out like this. This is all the fancy about the strap. Very simple. Just pretty much make a pocket that is really tight. That is pretty much just for, the buckle itself. And then the back one, you can leave it a little bit more open. You could even create a double pocket so you have a smaller pocket up here and then this pocket here if you wanted to. That's an option. You have the option of creating the side pockets as well. You could add pockets in the insides and turn it into more of a real purse, if you will. But this is it, you guys. This is my little purse for today. So now we have these two babies. And this one's bigger than this one. And they're the same dimensions, but the difference is that these sides come out a lot more than these on this side. Either that or it's the fact that the paper's black. Nope, it's definitely a lot bigger. This one's bigger than this one, and it's the same dimensions. So at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. You're going to be able to create different styles out of one template, so just be aware of that. So it's worth kind of learning how to do it. Once you learn how to do it, the dimensions are not really that important, I think. Because you'll be able to pretty much just do it off the gate. You'll know how it's supposed to look. And then you could just go from there and create your own style. Once you know where it folds and everything else, then the rest is, creations. Creativity. So with that, you guys, I'm going to let you go. And sugar darn it. I gotta see the damn glue gun. I'm telling you guys, it's a conspiracy. It left one little drop of glue right in the corner of my purse. I'm going to have to fix that. I'm going to have to add trim to this whole bottom line just to cover that little dot because I can't deal. That will drive me crazy. But here we are, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me on another Saturday with Let's Create Live with yours truly. I appreciate it. And definitely, if you get a chance, give this video a thumbs up. I would greatly, greatly appreciate it. And stay tuned because I think this is going to be an every Saturday situation at 6 p.m. And let me know in the comments down below. If you guys do want to do this flower tutorial, let me know if that's something that you guys want to see because I'll definitely get my dyes and everything together and we'll go through the whole process live. And we'll make some by hands and we'll die cut some and we'll mix and match some and we'll just make all kinds of pretty little flowers that you guys can use on all your kinds of crafty projects. So, thank you guys so much, and I will catch you guys later on. Have a good weekend. Bye.